Our next organelle is the mitochondria, and this is most commonly known as the powerhouse of the cell. Specifically, what that means is the mitochondria is going to convert glucose, which is a simple sugar, into ATP through a process of cellular respiration. The mitochondria has a double membrane, just like the nucleus, except while the nucleus has just two sort of circular membranes, one inside the other, in the mitochondria you have this outer membrane, and then the inner membrane has all this series of folds. Here's one of those structure function alerts. All of those folds allow it to have more surface area to do more chemical reactions. And if this is the organelle that's making energy and ATP for you, you want lots of surface area so that you can make lots of ATP. Mitochondria are found in both plant and animal cells. The lysosome is a small package of digestive enzymes. And it's going to be the recycling organelle of the cell. So it's going to break down old organelles that aren't working anymore into their component parts. If you have protein complex carbohydrates that aren't being used, you want to break those down into the amino acids and the sugars so that they can be used to rebuild things. Cells are very, very efficient in how they use everything that occurs inside the cell. We can use some Latin roots again here. Lyse means to break apart, and some refers to body. So this is the body that breaks apart things, or the organelle that helps break apart things. The lysosome can also act as a suicide organelle. If the cell needs to die for various reasons, the lysosome will release all of its digestive enzymes and actually digest the entire cell away. At first, that sounds sort of horrible, but there's actually times when you want cells to die. For example, as you're a developing embryo, you actually have webbing between your fingers, and at a certain time in development, the cells in between those fingers die, so that you can move your fingers and they're no longer attached. The other one would be if a cell is under attack by a virus, it might make sense to digest itself before those viruses can be released to infect other cells. Vacuoles and vesicles. These are membrane-bound organelles that are used for long-term and short-term storage inside the cell. So they can hold water, they can hold nutrients, they can hold hormones that have been produced and ready to be released. Think about them just as the storage closets. Vacuoles tend to be a little bit bigger, vesicles tend to be a little bit smaller. Vacuoles are longer term, often around for months or years. So the vesicles tend to be shorter term, helping move molecules from one place to another, maybe lasting a matter of minutes or hours. Different things they can store: water, enzymes, hormones, food particles. So here we've got a picture of a little vacuole. They are multifunctional. Next, we have the endoplasmic reticulum, better known as the ER. It's depicted here as this yellow set of membranes around the nucleus. And in fact, it's made entirely of membrane that is contiguous with the outer layer of membrane on the nucleus. There are two kinds of endoplasmic reticulum. The rough ER is rough because it's embedded with ribosomes. And the rough ER is going to help finish building and then transport proteins. The smooth ER doesn't have any ribosomes in it. Remember, ribosomes are what build proteins. So smooth ER is going to be involved in other things, particularly lipid synthesis, so building lipids, and also detoxification, so bringing in molecules like alcohols and breaking them down into component parts that are not so dangerous for your cells. Next, we have the Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus is this series of flattened membranes. This one has been cut in half cross-section so you can see those different parts. This was named after Dr. Golgi. What it's going to do is process and modify proteins and lipids that come from the ER so that they're ready to function. So here the nucleus has the instructions to build the proteins. The proteins are then started here in the endoplasmic reticulum, the rough ER, and then they move through vesicles to the Golgi apparatus. And the Golgi apparatus is going to put different proteins together to make a functional protein. Maybe it's going to add sugar groups to that protein. Maybe it's going to add an iron. This is the final packaging. Once it leaves the Golgi apparatus, it's ready to go out into the cell to do work or out to the cell membrane to be sent to some other part of the body. The centrioles are these little dark pink cylinders. They are a complex of tube-like fibers. They're going to be really important in moving and guiding the DNA when cells divide. So they're going to be essential to mitosis and meiosis. And we'll talk about those a little bit later in the semester. Most of the life of the cell, they're just sitting there waiting for the one time they're needed in the life cycle of the cell. The cytoskeleton. This is a series of long tubes and fibers, and they stretch throughout the inner cell all the way to the plasma membrane. They're going to hold organelles in place. They're also going to serve as a series of highways to help move and guide molecules and organelles inside the cell. And they're even going to be involved in communication. It turns out that the cytoskeleton inside one cell is attached through the cell membrane to the cytoskeleton in the next cell. And so they can actually physically communicate by pulling on some of these tubes and fibers to communicate from one cell to another. I think when I first learned about cells, I pictured a membrane kind of like a water balloon with everything sloshing around in the cytoplasm inside. In fact, the inside is a lot more organized than that, and it's largely because of this cytoskeleton. The video that you're gonna watch is one of my favorite because it actually shows this complex cytoskeleton. So here, these lines are actually the cytoskeleton tubes and fibers. And then this is a vesicle that's being pulled along by a walking protein. And I'm gonna describe this briefly so that you know what you're seeing in the video. This is this amazing protein called a walking protein. It's got these two little feet on it. When you add ATP, one side will lift up, and then the ATP falls off and it will fall back down. Then you add ATP to this foot, it lifts up and then falls down. But when it falls down forward a little bit. And so this protein actually walks along the cytoskeleton fiber and carries this vesicle to its next location. So please enjoy this video. It is a computer model of what we think the inside of the cell looks like, but it's one of the best depictions I've seen of the complexity of all of these different organelles.